trying to link up. So much we got synced up. Pulled up in the dinged up whip. This ain't Pepto Biz with this pink stuff. Here's on tell me. Yeah, you heard me, you ain't felt me. I've been moving, I've been shaking, going, hit me on the celly. Try to sell me on something while I hold it compelling. Ever since I've been gone like Kelly, they been trying to tell me about this and that. I ain't chatting with you, we ain't going tit for tat. Trying to tell me how to get in the bag. We're going to get in the bag, I'm about to get in the. Automatic is a habit, you should know it's automated. I've been getting to it, I ain't noticed y'all was hating. Brand new chick, she don't know that I can pace it. I just wanna know that I can hold a conversation. Oof, I don't know what y'all debating. I've been waiting for you, now I'm running out of patience. Running up a check, trying to run an operation. Went broke in the check and put 100 out of savings. And I can tell now that you ain't talking about nothing. I'ma need something I can calm down front. I'm gonna pull it with the bar down one. 6 months saying I ain't once. Trying to tell me what you know about me. You don't know nothing, keep it real with me. She said she ain't trying to deal with me. Okay, cool, you can sell that C.
We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I had to tighten the plan. Yeah, I got it right in the end. Ay. Now we on top, top once again. I don't want it if it ain't love. If it ain't get it away from me. Who you gon' jack if it ain't us? LABB to the bakery. Some mad that I came up. I know my granny gon' pray for me. It was just us in the vacancy. We had to get it from A to B. Wheels never felt like this. Two seats in the hills, how I feel righteous. Blue sheets for the mills, but the deal priceless. New keys can't care what's built private. I might just double it up, did it. Never enough, I'm with it. 5-2-3 on the business, whole team got wins. And the wheels suspended, I told them. What I told them. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah, hey. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top. Got a spot and it's locked to the click all in. I got ops, if he drop, I just hit my dance. I was top, they just watched, had to take my wins. They wouldn't let me in, I've been on 10 cents. Who really holding it down, I've been holding it down and I go it again and again.
We are pleased as always to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Miami Dolphins and the Atlanta Falcons. Both of these teams about to reach the halfway point of this NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports.
And they will elect to not bring this one out as our first drive will begin at the 25. First and 10, and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. Three tight ends are out there.
They'll run for the first time here with Matt Breida. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
At the 23, it's second and 12.
Tagovailoa working out of the gun. He's going to loft one. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Jakeem Grant, 77 yards. And the Dolphins are going to take a first quarter lead.
Well, if they didn't get the wake-up call before the game, they got it right now. Two plays already in the end zone.
I think of it in boxing terms because whether it's a big shot with your first one or a probing one, a little bit of a jab, the second one was the payoff. That was the big one that landed. 1-2, end zone.
Extra point up and good by Sanders, and that makes the score 7-0. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes.
And a short kick taking it about the 16.
A lane opens here. He's past the 30.
The Falcons take over first and 10 at their own 31-yard line.
The Falcons now come up first and 10 at the 31-yard line. And he'll be tackled just past the 35 at the 36. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. A gain of 13. It's a first down. Although his reputation as a speedy runner precedes him, it's always fun to watch him work.
It is eye-opening, isn't it? Because when you see him get the ball and just go, in addition to that speed, it helps out his blockers. They don't have to hold blocks for long because he's just going to speed right past them.
Here's the first carry now for Todd Gurley. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high power, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, you give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout. And that means your offense has to keep pace.
Hands it off out of the gun. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And he'll work free from one tackle, but that's about all as he's taken down. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense. What's that, five straight runs?
Yeah, five straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. From the 36, McSorley. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. 5 yards on the pickup, and they'll be faced with a third and inches. Toss out right, and there he goes again. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. 15 yards, first down, Atlanta. That time the conversion comes courtesy of the RPO.
And know what it did? It moved the sticks. Nice pickup on third down, even better decision.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And able to get him down, but he does reach the five.
First down.
10 more there and another first down.
At the 5-yard line.
First and goal, and a chance to get that initial touchdown right back.
Let's make these babies cry.
Go, go, go!
Whip, whip, whip,
whip. Gonna give this time to the tailback. Hammering for the goal line. He loses the football. And this is picked up by the Dolphins. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Partner, you know how often we hear about the red zone, right? From the 20-yard line going in, that scoring zone, getting points on the board. A lot of teams call from the 10-yard line in the green zone. That's your money zone. He fumbles the ball inside the money zone. You have one job, take care of the ball. That didn't happen.
Very fortunate to get another shot. Here's second and goal. Running back, and he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. No gain on the play there. They're going to need to come up with something better here on third and goal. They'll come out in the pistol. Big play coming here. It's third and goal. For this, and he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first. The keeper nets him only a yard, and that's going to bring up fourth. Defense didn't budge on third down. Now what are we going to see on fourth?
We are soon to find out, but does this feel like old school football or what?
Oh,
right?
Yeah.
This is an old-fashioned goal line stand. I know what I would call on offense. I would go for it, and I want some type of a play where my quarterback has a chance to run it or throw it. I don't just want one static play.
Gets it out quickly here to the left flank. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Russell Gage, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Falcons are an extra point away from tying the football game. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7.
Again at 7. To kick off for Atlanta.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Taken about 7 yards deep.
The Dolphins take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And, Charles, if the season ended today, and it's not going to, we still have December left.
More football.
We're only in November. But they would be a wild card team. And that's great. They'd be in the playoffs, but you know they're trying to bump up to be one of those division leaders.
That guarantees you at least one home game in the playoffs, and that's what you're really seeking. But there also isn't much margin for error for this team, right? Because right where they're sitting, a 2-game losing streak could have them out of the playoffs, so they've got to make sure they continue to keep the momentum going.
Absolutely. There's some sharks smelling blood in the water behind them. These two teams all tied after one. Two and now on first down. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays.
First down, Dolphins.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Going to the air, Tagovailoa. Open man, it's Preston Williams. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down.
Gain of 18 on the play.
Well, it certainly doesn't matter if it's been through the air like on this play or on the ground. I don't know what's going on with this defense. In a sense, they've been AWOL on this drive so far. Three plays, three first downs given up. They've got to find answers, and they've got to find them quick.
On first down, here's Breida. And he will be brought down at about the six-yard line. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
Well, think of it like you would a typical boxing match. The person that's on his heels and absorbing blows is having a tough time. And that's what's happening to the defense right now, because the offense is on his toes and punching. And there was another first down run right there.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. This one back to the five-yard line, but no further than that. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal.
No gain on the play.
And that's called winning at the point of attack, isn't it? Right there at the line of scrimmage. I know he's a little bummed out now. He doesn't get credit for a tackle for a loss, but no gain, his guys will take that.
And speaking of winning, to be as cheesy as we can, he was the winner of the NFC Defensive Player of the Week award from last week, so he's really stringing together some good football.
So not only did he get a gold star, he might have gotten a gold watch too, huh?
Eluding the pressure right. This is caught. Watkins. 5 yards that time on the completion, and now it's third and goal. A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. They'll try to run with Breida. Boy, no chance as he was met and dropped behind the line there. Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's fourth down.
One word comes to mind to me after that last play, and that's alert. That defense took a chance guessing the snap count, and they were so right. Got great push up front, and that forces fourth and goal.
So on fourth down, Dolphin kicker Jason Sanders comes on. This is less than an extra point, just a 19-yard attempt. The kick by Sanders is good. And the Dolphins will jump out to a 3-0 lead. So it's an old-school extra point that counts three times. It's certainly a disappointment they weren't able to get it in the end zone.
Yeah, I can just imagine post-game, head coach looking at the box score, 19-yard field goal, grimacing a little bit. But having to realize it at that moment, getting 3 points was vital. Go ahead and get the points, put them on the board.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And you know, it's certainly a lot of football left to play. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're in first place in their division, looking really good and looking to be a threat come January.
And are you one of those early holiday shoppers, partner? Are you one of those guys, get your list done? Because I think about what every team has on their holiday shopping list right now. What's the number one goal? Make the playoffs. Number two, win your division. Number three, and I think the biggest goal of all, try to get the number one seed so you get that first round bye and ensure you don't have to go anywhere in January and hopefully get to the Super Bowl that way.
At the 34-yard line.
From the gun, he'll hand this off. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. A gain of 13. It's a first down. All right, I got to ask you, with these RPOs, essentially the quarterback has three options, right? So what's different from that versus the triple option that we see the service academies run at the college level?
As a general rule, the triple option at the college level, most things are called outside of the quarterback faking it to the runner and then keeping it himself and maybe having a trail back. What I mean is, in the NFL, that option to throw the football, all comes about organically. It's a natural deal based on reads. In college, if you're going to throw the football off a triple option, you've actually called that play.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
2 minutes remaining in the first half, 10-7, our score. A reminder coming up just a few minutes from now, we'll send you to Jonathan Coachman and our crew in Orlando. Coach will have a look back at some of the stats and scores from yesterday's action. Looking to throw again on second down. Ryan to the right side and complete to Hurst. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down.
Well, they were unable to make anything really big out of that, but it's not a bad idea to find your tight end and give him an easy completion and keep moving things forward. Almost as bread and butter as a good running back dive play.
On third and one, Ryan looking for his running back, and he's got him. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. It'll be a gain of 6 that time as it moves the chains as well. Taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call. Inside handoff. That's a gain of 6 on the first down run.
For the running back, Jerome Baker in on the tackle.
Play action. It's Ryan. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off, Byron Jones. And he is all the way up past the 25. He had a little bit of the turnover bug last week, 3 interceptions. Not an absolute disaster, but another one here. Do you start to get a little worried?
You worry about your team as a whole because you have to find a way to make those interceptions, quote-unquote, go away. And that means your defense. They've got to go out there on sudden change and at least hold people to field goals. And if that keeps happening, they lose confidence in the quarterback, and then no one plays well.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. He's brought down. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down. 3 tight ends in the ball game here on first and 10. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Now Tua. Throw right side, complete to Williams. The Dolphins going to take their second timeout. As it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number one.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Tagovailoa to throw on second down here. And that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. throwing is Tagovailoa on third down here.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Darquez Denard.
The third down pass. Intercepted. The Falcons take over first and 10 at their own 16-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And the ball backed way up, so thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball, just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down.
Jones on the coverage.
And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. Final play of the half. It's Ryan. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. So we've hit halftime, just a field goal separating these two teams at the break. As we'll send you down to Orlando, and we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. It'll be Falcons football, and they trail here as we get back underway on EA Sports. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is...
It's caught inside the 25. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Calvin Ridley, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Falcons have retaken the lead.
For the extra point.
And that makes it 14-10.
Kick is good. Makes the score Falcons 14, Dolphins 10. Matt Bosher to kick off for Atlanta.
Now after the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. This will make it into the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Second and 12 at the 20-yard line.
The opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. From the gun, it's Tua. Being chased out left. Complete to the running back, Matt Breida. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
It's 2 and now on first down.
He's going to loft one deep left side here. Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted. Picked off near the 26. And his guys will take over at the 25-yard line.
At their own 25-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook. One play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was fairly easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
And we'll see if it's that easy here. After the pickup of five, here's second and five. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
From the gun, they'll try to run it. And this winds up a pickup of two, maybe two and a half, to about the 39.
He's brought down.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
He'll pitch it. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and they're left with a third and eight.
It's now third and eight.
Third down, Ryan. It's caught, Jones. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. That his first catch so far. They've held him under wraps, but he's got a first down there.
At the 50-yard line.
Midfield now. Here's Ryan. And his throw is incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Third quarter on a Monday night with a second and 10 coming up. Here's a handoff out of the gun. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Seventh play of the drive upcoming here on third and six. From the gun, it's Ryan. Looking long for his tight end read. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact. But in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
Here's Matt Bosher now, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. Officially, that'll be marked down as just a 28-yard punt.
And the Dolphins' drive will start deep in their own territory with a first and 10. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. Quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Breida. And a short gain across the 15 to the 17-yard line. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and 7 ahead.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense, and guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time, but you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
They fake the handoff. Now Tua. He's got his man. It's Williams. And he's able to pick up the first down here before he goes down at the 26. Tua finding Williams for a Dolphin first down.
First down, Miami.
One quarter remains here as we wrap up the week on a Monday night. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. On first down, Tagovailoa. This is complete to Watkins on the slam. He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. 25 yards there on the catch and run. That's the number two receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage. And tell you what, a few more plays like that, he won't be number two for long.
Well, that's what often happens when you have competitors running around the field. These guys know where they stand in relationship to yardage, totals, numbers, the whole deal. And let's face it, all of them, they all want to be number one.
From Falcon territory now, here's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. They'll set up a screen for Breida. No gain on the screen there at second down.
But that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. The completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3.
And a lot of times these plays, they either go for nothing or they go for big yardage. And here they got to the outside, turned it upfield, and ended up getting a nice little gain out of it.
The Dolphins on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 3. Tua setting up shop to throw again. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. Then all the way in for a Miami touchdown. A big play there. His 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Dolphins are once again going to retake the lead. A nice throw there by the second-year quarterback.
And I don't believe that was the kind of play he would have made as a rookie, because usually your rookie season is a continuation of your college days. A lot of one read, and if you don't have it, you just take off and go. Now he's settled in the pocket a little bit more, reading the field and getting to a second and sometimes third progression. That was a nice play.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Charles, this one not over, certainly, but you set the magic number earlier in this game at 20 points, said that they would need to hold them right around that marker under it. And what are you seeing here?
Well, that number is still in play because we said, okay, 20 or under gives them a chance to win. Right on pace for being in that range. And guess what? They've got a shot.
And he is going to lose yardage here. Number 2 yards, the loss, 2nd and 12.
Oh, partner, that play brought back memories. Watching them string it out, letting the runner get all the way to the sideline area, but not letting him get out of bounds. They formed that picket fence and didn't allow him through.
Not only that, got him for a loss as well here. And one of the reasons they lead in the fourth quarter, plays like that.
Yeah, it took a little more time off the clock, making him do it that way, didn't they?
On 2nd and 12, Ryan airing it out, looking for Ridley. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be 3rd down.
They'll probably spend a little extra time dissecting the game film after this one. I think the part of their plan was to hit them over the top with the deep ball. They've been unsuccessful all night.
The Falcons on 3rd down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is 3rd down and 12. That's out to the left and complete. Oh, good footwork on the spin. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. A nice pickup there, 18 yards. 1st down, Falcons.
And here we are in the 4th quarter, partner, and watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know, this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there. Not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
Throwing on 1st down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. Got out of the pocket, didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles, so just gets rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, make the right choice, get rid of it, live to fight another down.
Here now is 2nd and 10, again from the 41. Gurley. They'll go option on 2nd down, right side. And once again, the Dolphin defense holds firm as they'll stop him behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, and now 3rd and 12. The Dolphins bring on an extra defensive back on 3rd down. Here's Ryan to throw. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he's got another 1st down as he's brought down at the Dolphins 33. That gain on 3rd down, good for 28. Some pretty good games all weekend. We may have saved the best for last. This Monday night game has been a dandy. And to give this time to the tailback.
He's got a first down and much more inside the 20.
And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. That's now a pair of explosive plays in succession, both north of 20 yards. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And this time they were ready for him as he's taken down at the line of scrimmage.
Jerome Baker.
Tackle that time by Jerome Baker out of Ohio State.
Brings up second and 10 at the Dolphins' 12-yard line.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Ryan. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down.
10 yards to go.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. From the shotgun, Ryan. And probably the wise decision there. No one open. He just throws it away. And that keeps the field goal on the table as it's fourth down. So two third down conversions on this drive, but not able to get a third. And now they deal with fourth down. A big spot now for Steven Goskowski.
Field goal, a 29-yard attempt.
And in his 15th season, he's able to get this one to go. And in the fourth quarter, this game is tied. I tell you, the life of a kicker. He has not been called on the entire game. He's over there by the net. But they send him out here in the fourth quarter and say, hey, go tie the game, will you? And guess what? He comes through.
I just don't know how they do it. I really don't. These cats are a different breed from you and me. That's a pressure kick, but that one was never in doubt.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
4 yards.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. They pick up 4 yards on that carry. So now if you're a play caller, you can do just about anything you want, but on the defensive side of the ball, you scramble a little bit. Now you're behind trying to figure out, do I need to blitz him? Do I need to pressure him? How do I gain an advantage on this snap?
Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. So the Dolphins have it as we welcome you back in. They've got a second down now as they search for a score to break this tie. He's going to air one out. He's got him. Complete. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. It's a gain of 35.
First down, Dolphins.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Now Tagovailoa. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6.
Complete.
Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. A game-winning field goal would be a chip shot from here. Let's see how they play it on first and goal. They'll run here with Edwards at a minuscule gain of maybe a yard from the 6 to the 5. The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. is in. Touchdown, Miami. A great effort there. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Dolphins have broken our tie as they take the lead.
Hey, that score deserves our respect, deserves our excitement. But I'm looking at the clock and I'm thinking, there's a long way to go in this one.
Ideally, they would have liked to milk a little bit more time off. Now on the other sideline, you start to get the crew together and say, this is what we practiced the two-minute drill for, right?
Yeah, you hope you've been in that situation before, and if you haven't, you just have the confidence, hey, let's go down there and get this thing done. But boy, that's a big score right there to give them the advantage.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. They're down here in a one-score game. But the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
Well, they have the opportunity now. Here's the execution. And he can't corral it. That would have wrapped it up if he'd been able to hold on. Instead, it brings up third down. Here's a quick throw out left. It's complete. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. Falcons going to use their third and final timeout as he'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game. So from the 36 now, first and 10. They'll look to throw. And he's going to have the hook up to Gage. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
A gain of four.
4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. Ryan to throw. And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Now let's see who this is on. In the pocket, chucked it away, flag comes down.
So you got to move a little bit, right? Know where you are on the field, have some awareness. Tackle to tackle. You got to get outside of that tackle box in order to get that done.
So now it's third and long, because remember, they also lose a down on the grounding call. He's going to let it fly. And nearly intercepted there. That would have been ball game if he had clinched it and caught it. Instead, it gives him one more chance here on fourth down. To his right. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And it's incomplete. So their final drive comes up empty, and with that, the ball game is over. So a victory here for the Miami Dolphins, and it took a big fourth quarter to do it, but bottom line, they got the job done.
Yeah, it is the bottom line, isn't it? A few anxious moments along the way, though, a few sweaty palms, not just for the team, but for their fans. As you mentioned, down going into the fourth quarter. How about the rally? How about the comeback? Getting it done on both sides of the ball, holding them when they needed to, and finding ways to get points when they had the football.
So for Miami, they close out this first half at a very solid 6-2. And they'll get another road date next week as their opponents will be the New York Jets. Meanwhile, for the Falcons, they'll fall to 5-3 with a loss. And they will try to get back in the swing of things next week on the road. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew here at EA Sports, I'm Brandon Gordon, saying so long, everybody.
Number two,